हेलो एवरीवन, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑफ मैकेनिकल वर्किंग ड्राइंग दैट इज MWM वी हैव कवर्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 3 दैट इज कन्वेंशनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन। हाउ टू गिव कन्वेंशनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन फॉर डिफरेंट मटेरियल, फॉर डिफरेंट objects, for different components of machine, we have studied. Now next part, there are different springs like spiral spring, cup spring. How to represent all these things are in front of you in the chart. They have given the title, for example spiral spring is there, disc spring is there, then its view, how it looks like in the section, and simplified drawing. So in examination, according to timing, if you have much more time, so you can draw all these things. For example, if cup spring or disc spring will be asked in exam, then you can draw view, section and simplified section. If the time period is less, then you have to decide which parts you want to draw among these three, but at least two parts should be drawn. And if there is only one part, for example in spiral spring only view is given, so you have to draw this view as it is. Fine. Now most important part, how to study all these things. See, these are the diagrams, helical compression spring, these are the 3D view, actual springs, helical extension spring, then conical spring, torsion spring, leaf spring, disc or billet spring. So disc spring is look like this, and you have to draw its view. Then disc spring, how to show, is given in this chart. Likewise, you have to study all these things. See here, compression springs are given. If the 3D diagram for this compression spring are like this helical compression spring, so in examination or in drawing sheet, if you want to draw such type of diagram, this type of 3D diagram, then it is time consuming, much more time consuming. You cannot draw properly within a time this helical compression spring, so that here the simplified drawing or view and section is given for cylindrical helical spring. Is it so? The cylindrical helical spring is having view, section and simplified version. If you mention in examination cylindrical helical compression spring and just this simplified version, then also one can identify this diagram is for cylindrical helical spring. No need to draw such type of complicated objects. Is it so? So like this way you have to study all these springs, fine, or all these components which we have shown in, okay. So you have to study like this way, compression spring, these are compression springs, You search it on the Google, how 3D diagrams will looks like, how the actual components are there, and then how to draw their simplified drawing. You have to study all these things, right? Torsion spring, cylindrical helical torsion spring of wire of circular cross section, and second is double conical helical tension spring with circular cross section. Okay, in this diagram we have these springs. So this torsion spring you have to draw like this way, view section and simplified. Again I am repeating, in your examination it is your decision, either draw three views or two views according to your time management in examination. Fine. Again, all these types of spring, type A, type B, type B, number of varieties of spring are available in the market. Compression spring, clock spring, torsion spring, tension spring, etc. All these things are available in the market itself. Now see, these are some few diagrams: clearance, counterbore, countersunk, screws in, tapped holes. Now more some conventional representation regarding the pipe fitting. Elbow joint, which is having 90 degree angle generally. Elbow 90 degree, we know that the pipe fitting, and the symbol is like this way. Elbow 45 degree, symbol is like this way. We have to draw two straight lines and you have to darken the central portion and just leave the two dots at the end of dark lines. So you will get the symbol. Then T, at your home, at any construction, all these things you have already seen. Just here what you have to do is remember these symbols, which will help you in examination as well as which will help you in your future also. Fine. This is just for your sake of understanding. Cap and symbol, reducer concentric, reducer eccentric, and the symbols. Here image is given, fittings are given, and butt weld symbol. And these are the threaded symbol. Two different diagrams are there. If you partitionate these two things, then elbow 90 degree can be drawn in butt weld symbol like this way, and elbow 90 degree can be drawn in threaded symbol like this way. Here we have to concentrate on the threaded symbol, elbow 45 degree. Same diagrams are there, just two different symbols are used. First one is in butt weld and second one is threaded weld. Okay, this is elbow symbol, then elbow 45 degree, T equal, T reducing, cap and reducer concentric and reducer eccentric. These 5-6 symbols are given in this chart, so you have to draw accordingly, you have to study accordingly,